Now, our final guest is a real estate consultant, NAREIT member, certified negotiator, and a former kindergarten teacher from Mexico. Her passion is helping anyone and everyone, and as an immigrant, has a special place in her heart for helping to achieve the American dream. Here to tell us her story is Monica Martinez-Chin. Monica, thank you for being here with us today.
Thank you for the invite.
So, Monica, you came from Mexico, like me. I was born in Tijuana. What part of Mexico are you from?
I'm from Mexicali.
Mexicali, okay, yes. So right along the border.
Yes, 2 hours from here.
So when did you make the hop over, right? It's just 2 hours, very close. When did you come to San Diego?
Okay, so I came here because I got married.
Okay.
So I got married back in 2004. Mm-hmm. At that time, obviously, I was a teacher, and I didn't want to leave my career. Like, it took me a long time to be there.
And working with children.
And I love working with them. Mm-hmm. So, but it was a time that I needed to make the decision. I decided to just move here with my husband, and I needed to start all over from zero because we didn't have family, we didn't have anybody here. And Mexicali is not like Tijuana, that everybody speaks English.
Yes.
Mexicali, the border is Calexico.
Yeah.
So everybody speaks Spanish.
Yeah. Exactly.
So when I arrived here, it's like I needed to learn English. I needed to start all over. I didn't know anybody. Yeah. And whoever passed for that transition is like you lost your identity.
It's hard.
Yeah, because it doesn't matter if you have a career, if you have a status,
it
if you have a level,
away.
Everything goes away. But I was in love. I started and I was just going to adult school and college and those private groups in downtown San Diego, like 5 to 7, just one whole year, all full.
You were committed to learning English.
Yeah, to learn English because I didn't know anything, just hi, hello, how are you?
Well, now you know so much more and you've gone into the real estate world. But at first you had to learn the language before even learning anything about real estate. But after you're here, you said for like a year, what did you decide, what made you decide that this is a direction you wanted to take?
My husband was the one telling me, you know what, you will be doing good in real estate. Like, you like people, and you are friendly, and it's easy. Yeah. I mean, with your personality, it will go.
Yeah.
At the beginning, I was hesitating because I was like, I mean, Bienes y Raices, that's the name over there. It's not popular in Mexico.
No, actually, it's not that. Now that you mention it, it's not.
So it's,
no.
It's not like a big thing.
No. You're like, I was a kindergarten teacher.
Yeah. It was something like that.
So then you decided, he told you real estate was the right path.
Yeah. So I started studying real estate pretty much at the same time that I was studying English. And I always had my little... I mean, we don't have iPhones at that time, so we have like a little thing to translate all the words.
Yes.
And I was doing that, and thank God I passed my exam.
Wow. So you first took the information in English, translated it, and that's how you learned it, and that's how you were able to pass it?
Certain words, because I already, I mean, learned some
by
English
that
at,
point,
by that time.
You knew, okay.
But obviously, it was too much vocabulary for me. It was too much at
the
beginning.
It was a learning experience.
It was a good experience. And, well, I just pushed myself just to do it. And, I mean, the only way I knew how to talk to people was with real estate because that was the vocabulary that I had.
Beautiful. Well, that's all you need because it seems like it's been working. It's gotten you here. So then you finally decided to just make it in real estate. And then you decided to focus on immigrants, right? Because that's, you feel a bigger connection to people like you.
Yeah, actually it's because, you know, every immigrant comes to this country with hopes and dreams.
Yeah.
Everybody wants the best for their families.
Mm-hmm.
And I know the feeling.
Yeah.
And when you have your home for the first time, it's like the biggest achievement in your life, you know?
For anyone,
We have too many obstacles, challenges, things that we need to done to get it done to be able to get there.
Yeah.
So it's something big and it's for the whole family. Obviously, we just want to be better.
That's beautiful. So now that you've been doing real estate, you've been helping a lot of different families like you. Is there any particular story that you just remember that you really connected with that family and it just made you feel really good to help them?
Oh, every story. I love all my clients. Yeah. But I remember two of them that are most powerful for me.
Yeah.
One of them, they are from Brazil.
Okay.
And they arrived to this country, she arrived in this country with just $4,000.
Wow.
And she didn't have anybody, she didn't know what to do or anything. And she was crying when she got the first home because it's special.
Yeah.
And just thinking about them, I feel emotional.
I felt the chills too.
But it was like a big achievement because
the American dream.
Yeah, the American dream. And another one, I mean, he doesn't know how to read. He doesn't know how to write.
Yeah.
And he was getting his investment property because he's a hard worker. He's working 6 a.m. to 6 p.m.
Wow.
Passing those driver licenses without knowing how to read. I mean, how he did it.
Yeah.
So those are really families that touch my heart.
Yeah.
Like, they are going with everything. And
they're trusting you.
Yeah, and trusting and making their life
well,
better.
I can tell by talking to you and just how emotional you got you really do feel a connection and you really do care about your clients. And this is a beautiful example for the people to see that you're honest, you're genuine, and you really are going to help them.
Oh,
I wish we had some tissues. Oh, no. This is beautiful because it's who you are. Thank you so much for sharing those stories with us. I'm sure you inspired a lot of people watching that maybe can relate to those people and maybe you can help them in the future.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Mm-hmm.